Good morning, Central Cabarrus. Today is Thursday, October 10th, 2024. Please rise for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now, an announcement from Mr. Smith.
Good morning. This is Mr. Smith wanting to introduce you this year to our digital citizenship curriculum through Neptune Navigate. This year, we're going to be doing things a little bit differently with little spots in the morning like this for the announcements, and then also some longer videos during your homeroom time throughout the year. Neptune Navigate's main goal is to help us realize some hard truths about our digital usage. The first one is that the average teenager spends 8 hours and 39 minutes a day in front of a screen. Imagine that spreading out within a year, and that is 131 total days within a year. This is why we want to talk about this, because so much of our lives, so much of our time, so much of our year is spent there. Stay tuned for more information about digital citizenship through Neptune Navigate.
The next hosted meeting will be on Wednesday, October 16th, during second period reconnect in Ms. Townley's classroom. Since other meetings are also meeting at the same time, please create your appointment e-hop pass to Mrs. Townley for this meeting. We hope to see you there.
Attention third period teachers. As we honor Hispanic Heritage Month, Mr. Smith and Mrs. Geraldo invite you to showcase your creativity by participating in a door decorating contest that celebrates the rich and diverse cultures within the Hispanic community. This is an exciting opportunity for students to express their artistic talents and learn more about Hispanic traditions. The class with the most imaginative door design will win a special reward: a free period in the library to enjoy traditional Hispanic games, fostering a fun and engaging environment for everyone to experience these cultural activities. And the winning teacher will receive a free planning period, allowing them to reflect and recharge. Be sure to have your doors decorated and ready for judging by October 15th. A few members of the office staff will be touring the halls to evaluate your hard work and creativity. Let's celebrate this vibrant heritage and make our school a colorful reflection of Hispanic culture.
What is your E after high school? Enroll, enlist, employ. Learn more about post-high school options by attending the Future Fairs hosted by Cabarrus County Schools. Thursday, October 17th from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Cabarrus Arena. Hundreds of colleges, career representatives, and military restructures will be in attendance. They're excited to meet you and answer your questions.
Celebrating Hispanic Heritage, a showcase of contributions. In celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month, Ms. Geraldo's Spanish 3 and Spanish 4 students have dedicated their efforts to creating engaging informational videos that highlight the lives and achievements of influential Spanish figures who have significantly contributed to American society. These videos do not only serve as a captivating educational resource, but also emphasize the rich cultural tapestry that Hispanic individuals have woven into the fabric of the nation. Students are encouraged to watch these informative presentations to gain a deeper understanding of the diverse backgrounds and accomplishments of these notable figures. Additionally, the school's library will host a showcase featuring students' country projects and profiles of famous Hispanic personalities, offering a unique opportunity for the community to learn and appreciate the profound impact of Hispanic heritage in shaping our society.
Hello, my name is Addison. I'm in Spanish 3 with Ms. G, and in celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month, I would love to talk about Antonio Novello, who's made a great contribution to our society. Antonio Novello was born in Fajardo, Puerto Rico on August 23, 1944. She became the first female and Hispanic United States Surgeon General in 1990. She retired in 2014 and currently resides in Washington, D.C.
The Black Student Union will have their first meeting on October the 4th during Reconnect in the Planetarium. If you have any questions, see Mr. Fan in room 404 or Dr. Colomisilla in room 171.
Men's basketball and open gym from now on will only be for a selective group. Anyone who will be interested in trying out for men's basketball, please make sure your physicals are up to date on Dragonfly and complete.
The 2024-25 Central Cabarrus women's basketball season is near. Trials will begin at the end of October. Any interested students should be registered on Dragonfly, with an updated physical in order to try out. Currently, for those who have registered properly, preseason workouts take place after school from 2:30 to 3:45, Monday through Thursday. For more information, please see Coach Blaylock.
Today's lunch will be Generoso chicken, teriyaki chicken, and vegetable dumplings, glazed carrots, cucumber salad, mandarin oranges, and fresh oranges.
The weather for today will be sunny, with a high of 72 and a low of 43, with a 0% chance of rain.
The SAT word of the day is encyclopedic. Definition is to be comprehensive in terms of information. Synonyms include complete and comprehensive. He has an almost encyclopedic knowledge of food.
You know, I'm really afraid of jack-o'-lanterns. Thank you for watching Central.
And have a great day.